words from the Old Testament and a challenge for us. So, Becky, I'm going to try to get this ready.
I'm a senior, and today I'm going to be reading from 1 Peter 5, 9 through 10. It says, "Resist him, standing firm in your faith, because you know that the family of believers throughout the world is undergoing the same kind of sufferings. And the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while, will himself restore you and make you strong, firm, and steadfast." Now, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that, assume that we have all, at some point in our life, undergone some sort of trial or hurt or pain or suffering. But this right here, this verse right here, that's proof that you're going to get through. That's proof that God has promised that you're going to get through. And there's proof that there's something good waiting on the other side of your pain. When Jesus died on that cross, he didn't go through it because it was easy or it made him, you know, feel good. I mean, because that was a hard thing to go through for him. But he endured the pain, the physical pain, the slander, the betrayal, and the death, all because he knew that you were on the other side of it. He knew that the good for you was on the other side of it. Your pain will convince you that there is no God, and your wins will convince you that you do not need a God. But there is a God, and he's here for you, and he's ready to help you get through that pain and your suffering. I'm here to tell you that God is not a God of pain and sorrow, but a God of joy and peace, and he absolutely hates that you have to go through pain. He absolutely hates it, and he says it right here that there's suffering, but it's a good but. Like we say at our church.
But.
There is good on the other side. There is joy on the other side, and he's going to provide that for you. So, but everyone is suffering, and I just want to encourage you to be different and to rely on him in your times of suffering, and not only in your times of suffering, but in your times of joy as well, because he wants to be there for you, and he wants to give you good things, and he wants to make you happy, and you have to let him. Thank you.
Amen.